myself Nirbhay and I am doing my practice at Patna High Court. I am here to discuss with regard to law as optional subject in UPSC. Law is one of the optional subjects that the UPSC offers its candidate in the IAS main examination. It is sometimes seen as an unpopular subject, unpopular optional subject, but it is not true. Many candidates take up this optional and is also has a very high success rate. It is perhaps because of that even non-law graduates now opt for the law optional in the mains examination of IAS. Here it is very interesting fact that as per the information released by UPSC in 2013 examination, 144 candidates have opted law as their optional subject. Out of them, 35 peoples were recommended for the UPSC interview. This gives a success rate of 24.3%, which is higher than all over optional subjects. Now, this is a question always comes to us, that who can take the law as an optional for UPSC exam. Some people might thought or feel that law as much like medical sciences is a highly specialized subject and it would be taken only if you are a lawyer. But it is not true. This is not a true situation. Of late, even non-law graduates have taken the law optional with flying colors in the examination. For instance, one Munish Sharma, who secured second position in All India ranking in the UPSC 2013, who is an MBA, had taken law optional. Now, I would like to discuss about the advantages of law optional. That what is the advantage? Law is a very basic thing. Everybody, and especially if you are preparing for civil examination, has some understanding of the fundamental of law, like what is right and what is wrong, etc. UPSC does not accept you to be expert in law. You don't need to be a law graduate to opt for the law optional in the IAS examination. It is a scoring subject. It is a very highly scoring subject. It is interesting and you can learn a lot about law by reading newspapers and following cases in the news. The two papers are application based and so you don't have to do a lot of mugging up. Topics like governance issues, RTI, relationship between organs of state, the exercise of discretion, etc. have significance in GS papers. The UPSC syllabus for law optional is limited and can be covered in a relatively short time. The questions are very predictable and have been repeated too. And most important thing that UPSC always try to avoid tough portions of the law like taxation, FEMA, etc. Things to be remembered for law optional, that how to prepare law optional for UPSC exam. Paper first, the important parts are constitutional and administrative law. You may get up to 3 questions on this, and you can expect a question on international law. In paper 2, it is recommended that you give examples of recent cases. Don't forget to give the legal point of view with legal terminology in each question. Cite relevant case examples, but to differentiate your answers, also give the philosophy behind every law. Dear friends, UPSC Civil Services examination is known as the toughest exam in India. The exam is conducted in 3 stages: prelims, mains, and interview. Optional subjects are considered as a vital part of UPSC examination. The mains exam or the mains stage is of IAS exam or UPSC exam, comprise 9 papers, including 2 papers of optional paper. UPSC aspirants choose the law as an optional subject in UPSC Civil Services. Since it is a high scoring, the marks fetched in the optional subject is a crucial factor in deciding the fate of aspirant. Previously, law was a less popular optional, but now it has been consistently attaining the attention of aspirants over in the last couple of years. The successful candidates have those who had law as their optional, have unequivocally prescribed law to all law graduates and non-law graduates, but the graduates from the law background may consider the fact that the law optional has a considerably more extensive syllabus than other optional subjects. UPSC law optional paper consists in 2 parts. First is constitutional law. First paper consists constitutional law, administrative law, and international law. And second paper comprises the law of contracts, law of torts, contemporary legal developments, and law of crimes. This is all with regard to the law as optional subject in UPSC mains examination. Thank you very much. Thank you.